Hello, attendees of Chi22. I am Keng Wei, and this is my teammate, Joseph. Today, we're presenting our submission for the student game competition, ESsense. It is a DIY electrostatic sensor system for simple contactless, motion-based inputs in games. When most people think of the word sensor, they think of complex electronics that are capable of reading all sorts of different metrics, things like temperature, light, sound, rotation, and movement. And indeed, these are all intricate devices that are difficult to build and repair on one's own. Well, what we'd like to showcase today is a simple DIY electrostatic sensor, or ES sensor. The sensors can be made out of easily obtained materials. Conductive materials like copper tape or aluminium foil, specific dielectric plastics such as PTFE, and a microcontroller such as an Arduino. When there is relative motion between a dielectric material and a conductor without contact, the free electric charges within the conductor are disturbed, inducing current within the conductor, which can be detected and processed by a microcontroller. The induced current changes with distance and speed between the two materials. In our local climate, the small induced current is sometimes too minuscule to detect. This is mainly due to our high relative humidity, which reduces electrostatic interactions between all objects. So to help amplify the input current received by the Arduino, we had to place this PCB between the ES sensor and the microcontroller. Though, in many climates that aren't as wet as Singapore, this component will not be necessary. With some code and calibration, we managed to turn this system into a motion sensor, where the dielectric is held by a player and moved, with the microcontroller detecting motion through the stationary conductor. The Arduino can then send a keyboard input to a connected computer. This sort of detection only enables momentary activation, almost like a contactless button of sorts. The simplicity of components, as well as our limited time, resources, and coding ability, did not allow for detailed motion controls like in video game controllers. Nonetheless, there are still a number of possibilities enabled by this system which we'll show later. When used together, ES sensors can detect time differences between the activation of separate sensors. In this example, we connected two conductor pads to different analog channels on the microcontroller. Depending on the order of activation of the sensors, the microcontroller is able to distinguish the direction of travel over the two pads. More refined detection is possible if the sensors are configured around some of the limitations, which we cover in our submission paper.
So now it's time for some of our sample demos. For our submission, we showcase the system working in the context we have here on screen. Motion-based controls are most intuitively used as a solution for embodied controls in video games, allowing players to mimic in-game interactions for greater immersion and more memorable gameplay experiences. This is the approach we adopted for every example we are about to show. So first up is Lumberjack Plus, our example of new controls for existing games. This is a simple web game from Telegram, a popular messaging platform, and its original inputs featured either left and right screen taps or left and right presses of the keyboard. Using our directional ESsense system we showed earlier, we made a tree stump that houses two conductor pads, while the Model X houses some PTFE. After processing the directional inputs from player's swings, the connector Arduino sends the corresponding key press into the computer, providing the relevant input. Next up we have Levitation Charm, our example of new context for existing games. This is a recontextualized version of Flappy Bird, a popular smartphone game that has unfortunately since been removed from app stores for good. Instead of tapping a screen to flap a bird's wings, the player instead flicks a magic wand Harry Potter style to levitate a feather and avoid obstacles. And finally, we have Conducting, our example of a brand new experience made possible with the ESsense system. Built using a playback speed function in P5.js, this game plays a music track in accordance with the tempo you swing a baton at. Players can try to match the original tempo of their song of choice, or they can try to simply mess with the song speed just for fun. It's quite hard to truly visualize what gameplay experiences are possible with this system, so I encourage you to check out our trailer and overview videos to get a better sense of how this game works. We have a number of other possible interactions that can be built in the system with our overview video and submission paper. With ESsense, we hope to develop a medium for those interested in DIY to build their own controllers with simple motion-activated gestures, one that didn't require specialized hardware and fixed configurations that had to work around said hardware. ESsense does have its limitations as a result of its flexibility, but it does work well to support controller innovation in the DIY community, especially with new possibilities provided by motion-based inputs. And with that, thank you for viewing our presentation. We hope you enjoyed it.